call to me, and I will answer you, and I will tell you what great and mighty things which you do not know. You know what? There's so much on that. So much that God is inviting us and excited to show to us great and mighty things. Do you believe that? God is excited to show unto you the great and mighty things that He has in store for all of us. You know, I heard a man that says, Lord, teach us to pray big prayers. So much of that we pray is just detail. He's asking God to let him pray a big prayer. You know what? Because many of his prayers are just detail. You know, I find that praise helpful and meaningful. It's not that the details doesn't matter, but actually it matters. But our prayer suffers because we have a little vision of God. Our prayer suffers because we have a limited knowledge of who God is. That's why tonight He's challenging us, come, call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great things, great and mighty things. You know, if we want to honor God, if we want to honor God, we believe what He says, and by that belief, we activate it by praying large prayers that requires that the only hand of the mighty God can answer them. That's a big prayers that requires an almighty God to answer them. You know, God is inviting us. God is inviting us to call unto Him, and that He will show forth unto us great and mighty things. During a drought in England, a pastor called a special prayer for God to send forth rain because, as I've said a while ago, it was drought. Then a woman named Mary came with an umbrella. And during the time, the cloud is bright, and actually it's cloudless, and the day is so bright. And members of the church are asking him, why did you bring umbrella? You know, Mary said, since we are praying for rain, I thought I should be bringing an umbrella. And the congregation chuckled, and even the pastor is laughing. But then, as they are praying, the winds rose, the clouds roll in, and sure enough, the heavens open, and down came a torrent of rain. What happened to Mary? Mary was dry with her umbrella while all the congregation going home wet. You know, that's what faith does. That's what faith does. Faith brings an umbrella to a prayer meeting when you are praying for the rain. You know, that's God is commanding us, speak to that mountain. That's why He says, I tell you the truth. The example that He has given to us, having a faith, I tell you the truth. If anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will happen, and it shall be done. You know, for a disciple to cast a mountain down to the sea, it required two things. One is he must talk to the mountain, and the second one is he must not doubt in his heart. Those two are quite humanly strange. But the question is, what's the hardest part in bringing the mountains into the sea? Well, many people would say having faith, or not doubting in the heart. I suggest, brothers and sisters, the hardest part of bringing that mountain into the sea is to stand in the front of the mountain and speak to that mountain and talk to that mountain. You know, what kind of person looks to the mountain and talks unto it? You know, if we will be doing that on a regular basis, people will begin to question your sanity, correct? Yet, exactly that's what Jesus is telling his disciples to do. Speak to that mountain and command that mountain. You know, when you speak to the mountains of your impossibility, you are doing what Jesus is asking you to do.